Stan Wawrinka hasn't really got going this clay season, but the Swiss powerhouse has a great chance to go deep in Rome this week and generate some confidence before the upcoming French Open. Wawrinka is a former finalist in Rome, finishing runner-up to Novak Djokovic in 2008, while he also made the semi-finals in 2015 before suffering a loss to Juan Monaco, who's just retired, in the third round last year. John Isner, meanwhile, is playing his first European clay court tournament of the season and has already equaled his best ever result in Rome by making the third round. Set to play their first match since 2011, who will prevail when Wawrinka and Isner step out onto court around 3 p.m. local time on Thursday, 2 p.m. BST. As is becoming the norm in the top half of ATP draws recently due to No. 1 Andy Murray's disastrous run of form, there is a tremendous chance for much of the remaining players to reach a Masters 1000 final. Albert Ramos Vinales took advantage in Monte Carlo, while Dominic Thiem reached the title match in Madrid. Who will take advantage in Rome and earn a shot at the title? Of course, third seed Wawrinka can't be spoken about in the same breath as Ramos Vinales and Thiem. He has after all won three Grand Slam titles, beating Novak Djokovic and Rafael Nadal in those finals, while he is one of the few men outside the Big Four who has won a Masters 1000 crown. But, at the same time, Wawrinka certainly isn't the most consistent player going around, at least not in the early rounds of non-majors, and considering he still captured just the one Masters 1000 title Monte Carlo, 2014, it's a superb opportunity for the Swiss to continue building his legacy. When he's playing his very best, Wawrinka is near impossible to stop, but the main challenge for the 32-year-old is getting himself in the right position and headspace mentally so that his best tennis can flow physically. Sometimes that's doing the hard yards in the early rounds, coming through scrappy, tough battles in order to earn a place at the business ends of tournaments. Wawrinka can struggle when he's not feeling great on court and can also succumb quite meekly, but there were good signs for him in his Rome opener on Wednesday.